You can put them back into the wild, definitely, but you have to do it responsibly and sustainably.
So we set up Running Wild Conservation to start breeding cats in captivity and to supplement the wild populations. That's our main goal, is to have these cats around for the next 3, 4, 5 generations.
The fact that she couldn't be rewilded was quite devastating, but this makes up for it. To know that she's gonna contribute positively to the wild cheetah population of South Africa. Let's go.
Kiki is a special case because of her injuries, and she would not be able to survive without our bond that we have with her and that she has with us. But cheetahs shouldn't be bred as a commodity to be sold to collectors and zoos all over the world, and they definitely should not be kept as pets. Cheetahs are in a threatened state. There are very few wild cheetahs left in Southern Africa.
In regards to cheetah populations, they are declining. And what we like to call it is functionally extinct, whether that be due to habitat loss, illegal trade, or even just mortality of their cubs out in the wild.
There's a huge illegal trade from the Kenya-Tanzania area across Somaliland into places like Dubai, Abu Dhabi. Many of those cubs are caught wild, crated, and shipped over on small boats.
They will follow a pregnant mom, steal those babies, and those cheetahs then eventually end somewhere living in a little cage. Literally caged next to a lion and a wolf and a tiger and a hyena. Those animals are living under a lot of stress.
90% of them usually don't make the trip. When they get to their destination, they survive a couple of months. That's normally the stress that kills them.
Their lifespan's really short, but the money is there, and it's easy just to get another one.
So there's that illegal trade in cubs, and then obviously there's the so-called legal trade in cubs, where animals are bred in captivity and sold to zoos or private collectors all over the world. That's the legal side, but in our opinion, it shouldn't be done. It shouldn't happen.
I don't know where it's going to end and if it's going to end, but raising awareness and changing people's mindset that it's cruel to have a cheetah in your backyard. It's cruel. That's not how it's meant to be.
Africa-wise is very bleak. The population's growing, the habitat has been taken over by farming industries. People that are breeding with cattle or sheep or goats have no place for free-roaming cheetahs on their property. These cheetahs get shot, they get killed. So the population in Africa is dwindling, and we need somehow to feed the pipeline to help the wild population be sustainable again.
Because we are passionate about getting animals back into the natural habitat, we don't want to have too many people up and down and screaming kids and vehicles. We lose out on a lot of money from that. You know, it can definitely help our work, but it's important to educate people about the plight of the cheetah.
Our only form of income is the odd donation now and then, and then we have a small volunteer program of international volunteers that come over, work with the animals, learn about them, and they pay a nominal fee to be here every day, and that's pretty much our income.
Yes! This is your food! Enjoy, Kiko!
I just turned 18, and I was lost with my study. I didn't really know what I wanted to do in my life, but I just known that I wanted to work with animals. So I started to do a lot of research on internet, on website, and I find Running Wild Cheetah, and when I find this, I was like, okay, that's exactly what I want to do now.
In the mornings, we go and check on all the animals, do a head count on everyone, check everyone's fine, and then we can rotate some of the animals to different camps. It's a really good enrichment for them. It's different smells and it stimulates all their senses. And then we start around 2-3 o'clock in the afternoon, start with preparing all the different food for the different cats. Every animal's got their own menu. This one gets 2 kilograms or 3 kilograms, whichever the case.
All right, so if we're ready, let's grab some bowls and we can go down to the small cats.
And then we collect all the food on the vehicle and then off we go. To them our passion, and they go back to the universities and friends and families, and you know, we need to get those people passionate about wildlife for the future, because they are future custodians.